Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A very warm welcome once again. I've shared with you the reason for us having a virtual event. I won't waste any more time. We've got a compact program this afternoon, and I'd like to delve straight into it. But thank you so much to all the scholars for making effort to join us. I acknowledge the alumni. I see you, Bangela, and I see some Siyandisa alumni from our previous years. Welcome, and thank you for making time to join us. I know you guys are writing exams. I would like to introduce myself to those who don't know me, but I'm sure most of you do. My name is Tsikizwa Bacela, a very tricky name, I think. And I am the program coordinator for the Siyandisa Foundation Scholarship Program. And I hope you will enjoy this afternoon's proceedings. And on that note, I'd like to just observe a few protocols by welcoming our special guests. Our guests of honor are really the students this afternoon. I would like to welcome each and every scholar online today. I'd like to welcome the principals. I see you, Mem Sirakalala, and a few others. Thank you so much for making time to join us this afternoon. I would also like to acknowledge a few of the departments of education. In fact, all of them, I'd like to believe all of you have joined us this afternoon from the various provincial departments. Thank you so much. All protocols observed, and I hope that we'll have a fruitful chat this afternoon and that you will also embrace what we have to offer our scholars. So before I get into the Siyandisa Foundation, I would like to just give a glimpse of today's proceedings. There's two components, mainly the program overview. And in the program overview, I will be going through the Siyandisa Scholarship Program itself, what we offer, what we're about, and then immediately delve into our class of 2021 scholarship recipients who have worked very hard to get here. So the Siyandisa Foundation, who is the Siyandisa Foundation? The Siyandisa Foundation is a registered nonprofit trust and public benefit association. Our registration details are on your screen, ladies and gentlemen. And I must indicate that all proceedings, or all proceeds rather, that are donated, sponsored, are channeled through the Siyandisa Foundation to all our scholars. So the benefit is really to all our scholarship recipients. The Siyandisa Foundation was founded by the Siyandisa Trust, who are our, technical challenges start right there. The Siyandisa Foundation was founded by the Siyandisa Trust. The Siyandisa Trust is a Black-owned investment company, just a bit of background on them. And they invest in multiple industry sectors. And we share the same vision. Our vision at the Siyandisa Foundation is birthed from the vision of the Siyandisa Trust. Even as I may not delve into the Siyandisa Trust this afternoon, you are more than welcome to visit the Siyandisa Trust website. But our vision is to really help grow South Africa through this scholarship program. So please browse the website for more details. The Siyandisa Foundation Scholarship Program, I want to share a little bit of information on that, who we are, what we do, why we do. The Siyandisa Foundation Scholarship Program is a scholarship with a difference. That's what I'd like to believe. I know that's what we do. We are very unique in our offering. We look to the future to grow excellence. And we do this by developing our future leaders, our executives, our entrepreneurs, our academics, and hopefully in the not so distant future, captains of industry and leaders within their communities as well. How do we achieve this in our program? We invest in demonstrated academic excellence. And you will see as I proceed with today's presentation, that the scholars who are in our program have displayed ability, capability, and really excel academically. We don't only invest in their demonstrated academic excellence, we also provide support and learning resources on various levels, as well as, I think the main thing is we believe in our scholars, we believe in our program. And I think that very word itself should speak to the uniqueness of our program. So our eligibility criteria, you'll see it should pop up in your screen, is that we admit South African citizens. So our scholars are meant to be and should be South African citizens. They should be Black, from African, Indian or colored, male or female. They should be in grade 12 in the year of admission. In this regard, it would obviously be, or in this case, it would be 2021, but the year of admission is grade 12. They should have achieved at least an average of 80% or higher in their final grade 11 results. They have to attend a South African school, and the guardians and parents, or guardians or parents, should be exempt from paying school tuition. So scholars need to display or show us that they really come from low income households and that there's a need for our support. We then move from that part to our selection criteria. And we select our scholars at grade 11, and the data is obtained through our relationship with the provincial and national departments of basic education, as well as directly from schools. So we do work in conjunction with the various departments, and as such, we obtain our data. That is where all of your information comes from, scholars. Qualifying candidates are then invited to apply via online application portal, and our applications are evaluated on merit. So each scholar needs to display their academic merit, but also they need to display why they feel that they are eligible to be part of our scholarship program. Our successful candidates are then notified via various platforms, which is why they're all here today. And I will quickly move to the program phases, the actual program, what CNDISA is about and what we offer our scholars, and the various components that make up our scholarship program. So the CNDISA scholarship program has different phases. The first phase is the phase in which the class of 2021 are in now, and that is from a high school level or a secondary support, where we afford our scholars learning resources and equip them with university preparation. We do this for the course of, or the remainder of this year and the course of their matric year. We afford them learning resources. I'll go into a bit more detail in my following slides, just on what those resources are. But the most important thing is that our intake is at a secondary level. So we don't identify scholars post high school. We identify our scholars while they're in high school, and we support them, provide support for them, and equip them with the necessary tools to enter the university or the tertiary space. Our second phase is once our scholars have transitioned from a secondary or a high school phase, is they enter into a tertiary space. Now, all of us know that that is not an easy space. It's really difficult. So what we do in our program is that we offer our scholars funding support and tutorship. In 2021, we're rolling out our tutorship program, and we are very excited about that, because in that we have our senior students. I'll also delve into that in a little bit more detail in my future slides, but we provide our scholars with funding support, most of who need it right at the beginning with the entry level of university. And immediately after we have done that, they are then absorbed into our tutorship program. I'll go into a bit more detail in a little bit on that. The new component, the evolving, I think the key word today, if I could quickly just mention, is evolution. Evolution of the program, evolution of the world, I think evolution of technology, evolution of our scholars. The keyword is evolution. And this is, for me, the most exciting part of our program, where we are also evolving to not just be a primary support program, but to really get involved in the careers of our scholars, in the lifespan of the university lives, but also beyond university. We do this through our bursary support, which is already in place. Some of you scholars would know, particularly alumni, you've benefited from this support program. And this is where I would really like to place emphasis to our sponsors, donors, and supporters, that we would like to enhance and harness our scholars. We would like to empower them further through our vocational training, internships, mentorship, and work programs. And I think this speaks mostly to our evolving program. We've moved from just being a high school and a scholarship program that speaks to a high scholar, but we'd like to take our program to the next level. We'll speak a bit more in depth on this point. So I'd like to share a little bit on the scholarship offering itself. The CIANDISA scholarship offering is composed of a few elements. I'll delve into each, just an overview of each, nothing in detail. All our information is available on our website if you don't get what you need to get in my presentation this afternoon. So we offer program support to our scholars. We've got a team of dedicated CIANDISA family members who offer program support from the time that we identify our scholars up until they actually are registered with the universities. Our program support is very comprehensive. I'm also part of that program support, so you will hear from me. Class of 2021, please don't grow tired of hearing from me. I'm going to bother you throughout the year. Our scholarship offering is made of our program support, our scholarship pack. We assist with the university enrollment. We help on applications. Many of our scholars have benefited from the coordination of applications to universities through our networks. We also help support and guide and really assist in this process of transitioning from high school into university in the broadness of that process. We then ensure that all our scholars are admitted into their various universities, that they have applied for bursaries or secure bursaries with regards to the program, and that they actually make the right career choices based on the subjects that they've elected in high school. An example that I can also share with you is, once our scholars have been admitted to universities, in our support with bursary applications, we are also a feeder scholarship for a Moshal scholarship program, as an example of further bursary opportunities and also the broadness of our network. Then we also have our scholarship offering, a CIANDISA scholarship pack. And our CIANDISA scholarship pack comprises of a backpack. It comprises of a Lenovo tablet and cover. It also has a Vodacom SIM card with 80 gigs of data per month. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you can agree with me that in this era that we are now in, nothing is more important than data connectivity. And we are really proud to partner with Vodacom in providing data to all our scholars and ensuring that even as schools open and close due to the pandemic and protocols, that they don't miss out on any part of their studies or the learning process. Our connectivity tools include, among others, a 3CX system, which is a telephonic system, where we are able to stay in contact with our scholars. We also conduct video conferencing with our scholars. They can also then share information, old question papers and so on our 3CX system. We also have Zoom, WhatsApp, Gmail. So the key here is that we need to stay connected. We're in an era, and I think the pandemic is proof that we need to stay connected, and there's nothing more important in this program. Our program has always essentially been about connectivity, and now it I think we're more relevant than ever in that regard. I'll move to the next slide. So in my next slide, I'm going to share just a few learning resources that we offer our scholarship recipients to give you a broader understanding of what exactly it is that we do. So our learning resources comprise of 50 hours of high definition video lectures by the best Free State grade 12 teachers. We have developed these videos specifically for our scholarship program. So it's a boutique offering, and we have identified specific subjects. I think they're called STEM subjects in the academic sphere, where it includes physical science, mathematics, English, first additional language, life sciences, accounting. And we then allow our scholars access to these videos per subject, and we've highlighted in those videos specific themes that address key areas that our grade 12s need to focus on during the curriculum year. We have also in 2021 launched webinar sessions with these top teachers, these very same top teachers, and scholars will share a bit more information on that post our meeting today. But this also helps to support our program. It helps to add value to what we are already offering our scholars. Now, the exciting part for me in regard to the high definition videos for all these subjects is that they are now all available on YouTube. And I would like and encourage all our scholars to go to our YouTube page or our channel, like, share, click away. These are available to all our scholars, to all our schools. Please do not use them for commercial purposes. This is really to benefit our community. This is really to benefit our scholars at large. And even as some may not be in our scholarship program, we would still like our reach and our footprint to really spread across and really live up to what we stand for at Siyandisa. So I encourage you, I'll have my eye on our YouTube channel. I wanna see a lot of shares. I wanna see a lot of likes. I wanna see some downloads here and there. But teachers, I encourage you to please participate with this and share the content. We'd also like some feedback because I know you're all professionals, of course. And I'd like some feedback on what you think of our YouTube channel, what you think of the lessons. Are they effective? Are we doing the right thing? But I believe we are. So please contact us, share your feedback. We look forward to hearing from you on that. You can search for the Siyandisa Foundation on YouTube. Each subject is organized as a playlist. So each subject you will see has different videos, and you are more than welcome to go through each. The tutorship and tertiary level, that is where our alumni are, and that is where we are now in our evolution, where in our tutorship program, from second year on, our scholars or our recipients can apply to become tutors to incoming first year students. Now, first year students, again, we're going to have a different family meeting on this one, but I really would like to encourage all our scholars to get involved. We would like for you, particularly the matriculants, who have no idea what university life is about, to really get involved with the tutors, touch base at whichever universities you are enrolled with or registered with, so that it doesn't feel so foreign once you land. I think there's a huge difference between high school and university. And I think this tutorship program will really give you the support you need. Our tutors are also remunerated and rated. So our tutors aren't just tutoring for the sake of tutoring. they are also rated. So your feedback as the scholars, first year students, is going to be important. Are your tutors doing what they need to be doing? Are you getting the kind of support we envision and we have in place for you in that regard? So please give us feedback on that as well. We also conduct health checks to help acclimatize or orientate our first years. I think most universities have first year programs where there's induction and so on. And our program wants to really complement what universities are already doing by absorbing our scholars and thereby helping them to acclimatize, to assimilate, and to really just grow accustomed to being at university. We want to enhance engagement and development. Again, this speaks to evolution. Again, this speaks to the core of our program. We want to do this through these various legs of our program. In my next slide, I'd like to talk about the graduate funding support. Our graduate funding support is a short-term bridging financial support system. And we assist our scholars. Most of you who are in university will know, those who've received bursaries and so on, that often bursary systems don't facilitate your entry into university. Most bursaries, even as you receive them while you're in matric, would normally only pay out later in the year for various admin reasons. We won't get into that today, but what our short-term bridging financial support is intended to do is to facilitate and really assist our students between matric and entering university in that very critical and crucial gap of acclimatizing, assimilating, and just getting the sense of what university is about. Our scholars need critical items, particularly at the beginning of the year, and that is what this support, this financial support is really for. We assist with academic registrations, with books, with accommodation, with deposits, with travel, with food support, with anything really that our scholars need while the bursaries are still pending. Our support fund is available throughout the year, or rather not even just throughout the year, but throughout your university career. So all our scholars are eligible to apply for support funding throughout your studies. And you will get more information, those who don't already have it, on how you can apply and where you should apply. This, for me, is the actual exciting part of the scholarship program, because I am as old as this toddler. I've been with the foundation forever. And as it evolves, as it grows, I am also growing and evolving with it. And we've got a new exciting component to our program, which is the executive development. Now, the executive development is just really a continuation of this journey. It is really to cement and enhance what we're already doing. The executive development program is really about the road to a successful career. Now, from matric to graduation and post-graduation, there are so many things that can happen in between. And we would like to keep you in the duration of your career, whatever field of study you may be in. We'd like to do this with the help of sponsors and partners. And this is where I call on our sponsors, on our partners, on our donors, friends of the foundation. We need your assistance here. We need your support here. We want to have a successful program. The executive development, we want to have holiday work for our scholars. We want to have vocational training and internships. We want to create a mentorship program. In fact, we have a mentorship program. We've got bursaries. So our sponsors, our partners, this is where you are most critical, most relevant. Most of our scholars are already high performers. We need your involvement here. We need you to take part and really get involved. Again, post this afternoon's proceedings, we can delve into more detail on how you can get involved and partner with us in achieving these goals. In my next slide, I would like to share a little bit about our alumni and our alumni program. So the lady you see on your screen is Refilwe Silepe. She is one of our first generation Siyandisa scholarship recipients. She is doing her MBCHB, medicine in other words, at the University of the Witwatersrand. And she's one of the grades of 2017. So she's first generation and doing very well. Now in our alumni network, we'd like to really build and cement a community who can also then invest their own time, their skills, their lessons in university to our future scholars, to our current scholars, and impart some knowledge and really give back to the future scholarship recipients. Everyone benefits from this network in that way. So we encourage you scholars who are our alumni and attending today, if you've lost contact with us, please get involved. We really, really would like to see you. We also want to harness a growing social network. My English airtime is running out. A growing social network to our top achievers. Our scholars have displayed academic ability and excellence, so they are really the top achievers. We want to also empower our Black male and female captains of industry from an early grassroots level all the way through to their career paths. And as I said, to really captains of industry and experts in their various fields of study. Our alumni invest back through this mentorship program, through guidance and support. So again, I appeal to our alumni who've lost contact. This is an opportunity for you to give back. I want to share a little bit about the scholars, the recipients, and our matriculation history, really. I did say I'm a toddler, so if anybody knows that I'm older than 4 years old, that's not my age. I'm 4 years old. I'm as old as Siyandisa Foundation. Our scholarship recipients have displayed incredible results over the years, ladies and gentlemen. You'll see our class of 2017 was pretty small, class of 25. They achieved a total of 136 distinctions all told at the end of grade 12, an average of 85.5%. In 2018, we see progression when the group also increased. We had a bigger number of scholars, a bigger intake, 50 scholars who managed to achieve 275 distinctions all told at the end of grade 12, averaging 86.1%. 2019 sees that number increase even further to 284 distinctions all told, an average of 86.4%. In 2020, 297, 87.1%, despite the COVID pandemic. I am proud of you, class of 2020. And our grand total of distinctions since inception is 992, averaging 86.4%. So record shows that these are the best candidates. Handpicking the best, our process is working, and class of 2021, grade 11s have outdone themselves. You are now class of 2021, and we are proud of you despite COVID. I think, Vanessa, I'd like to just give a round of applause here to all our achievers, because I think these numbers are really speaking to the core of the program. So if you could unmute just for 2 seconds, and I would like to just say congratulations to everyone.
Congratulations.
you. Thank you, Vanessa. All righty, thank you so much for that round of applause. No pressure, class of 2021, no pressure at all. 87.1, what's 87.1? I think you can exceed 300 distinctions, but we'll have a chat, another family meeting again on that. I'd like to, in this slide, speak to our partners and speak about our partners, because without our partners, the program would not be possible at all. Each and everyone who's involved in our scholarship program contributes immensely. To you, it might seem like a small contribution wherever you are, but I can tell you, because I work with all these scholars, each and every single scholar by name, any small contribution that is made makes a humongous difference. And I would also like to just say our partners contribute in various ways, as I've just said, through funding and monetary support, through donations, through these executive development opportunities, which links up with some of the sponsors who give or donate bursaries. But I want to encourage our partners to adopt a scholar. Please adopt a scholar. Give them that opportunity. Give them that chance. Take them through this journey, evolve with them. Don't just give in terms of monetary support, but also really add extra value to what we are already doing through adopting a scholar. I'm gonna challenge all our partners. I know most of you are here today. I'm gonna challenge each and every one of you to adopt a scholar. I don't wanna have a Siyandisa scholar who doesn't have an adopted organization by the end of 2021. So the challenge is on. Now I move to part two of our program. But before I do that, I would really once again like to unmute everyone and just share the celebratory spirit and say thank you, class of 2021. You have outdone yourselves. You've really worked hard. You deserve to be here. Keep working hard, but more than anything, I celebrate you. We celebrate you as a Siyandisa Foundation. So, Vanessa, please unmute so we can give another round of applause. Well done.
Well done.
The host is muted.
Is the host muted?
I'm sorry, well done, well done.
Thank you so much. I think my TV career might begin today. I'd like to believe my TV career begins today, but let's first go through our 2021 50 scholarship recipients before anyone can give me feedback on whether I'll make a great news reader. But I think so far, so good. Our first, in fact, before I even start with the scholars, I'd like to just indicate that this class of 2021 are a very strong academic group from 8 of the 9 provinces. We have 23 boys and 27 girls. And as usual, the girls have outnumbered the guys. So well done to all the ladies. We are proud of you. Keep working hard. No pressure, guys. I'm going to announce each recipient in alphabetical order. So please bear with me, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to go through our scholars, and at the end of this part of the program, we can then give a round of applause to all of them. So our first scholarship recipient of class of 2021 in South Africa is Kelly Ann Alagapen. Kelly Ann is from KZN, the Warm Province, Little Flower Combined School, and her principal is Mr. Zuma. Kellyanne comes into our program with an average of 83%. Well done, Kellyanne. We are proud of you. We then have Kensani Baloyi. Kensani is from the Gauteng province, from Sikululekile Secondary School, and her headmaster is Mrs. Tweni. Welcome back, Mrs. Tweni. You always give us scholars every year. I know that you'll have someone in our program. And Kensani comes in at an average of 87% at the end of grade 11. Well done, Kensani, and welcome to the program. Joseph Duda is from the Western Cape, from Sophumelela High School. And the principal, Kitso, please pay attention, is Mr. Once again. And Joseph comes in with an overall average of 82%. Well done, Joseph, and welcome to Siyandisa. Bianca Dube is from Limpopo Province, EPP Mhinga Secondary School. And the principal is Mr. Chauke. Welcome back, Mr. Chauke. Overall average for Bianca is 82%. Well done, Bianca. Keep working hard. Sibonga Bonke Faleni is from the Western Cape. From now, this is where I think I'm going to have a technical glitch because they did explain that the name might be a bit difficult. New Ileben High School. Overall average, 84%. Well done, Sibonga Bonke. Please forgive me for mispronouncing your school if I did. Bianca Khaditsi is from Limpopo Province, Randubeng Secondary School. Welcome back, Randubeng. Principal is Ntate Rapula, and average for Bianca is 88%. Aka Kumalo from KwaZulu-Natal, or KZN, is from Little Flower Combined School. Principal Babu Zuma, welcome and thank you for being here this afternoon. Her overall average is 84%. Sebenzile Sisi, well done. Anelka Mabinani is from Limpopo Province, Jane First Secondary School. Welcome back, Jane First. I think we haven't seen you guys since 2019. Principal is Mr. Ndage. Overall average for Anelka is 80%. Well done, Anelka. Silubonile Matikane is from the Western Cape. Again, that school pronunciation, please forgive me. Overall average for Silubonile is 80%. Such a tongue twister, your school, Silubonile. Congratulations and welcome to Siyandisa. Someleze or Someleze Madolo is from the Eastern Cape of Imvaba Secondary School. Principal is Mamu Matabata. Overall average, 90%. Well done, Someleze, and welcome to the Siyandisa family. Mpapatse Mahapa is from Limpopo Province, from Randubeng Secondary School. Principal, again, is Ntate Rapula. Overall average, 88% at the end of grade 11. Well done. Collins Makhetwa is from Limpopo Province, Randubeng once again, Ntate Rapula, an 87% accomplishment achievement. Well done, Collins. Keep working hard. Zovuyo Manilana is from the Eastern Cape of Imvaba Secondary School. Principal is Mrs. Matabata. Overall average, 81%. I must just mention, Wena Zovuyo, that Kofimvaba is next to Bakela village. So my origins are right next door to you. Well done, you're representing. Hlanganiso Mathebula is from Limpopo Province, EPP Mhinga Secondary School. Principal Ntate Chauke, 82% average at the end of grade 11. Well done, Hlanganiso. Welcome to Siyandisa. Mpho Matimela is from Limpopo Province, Jane First Secondary School. Ntate Ntake, 85%. Well done, Mpho. Welcome to Siyandisa. Bongiwe Mayane is from the Free State Province, Sechaba Simaketsi Combined School, Ntate Murobi, 81% overall average. Welcome, Bongiwe, and congratulations. Lee Kombuka from the Eastern Cape, Province, St. Matthew's High School. The principal is Utatu Ngoba. Overall average 81%. Sebenzile liko. Continue, Puti. Tikere Monga Omonda. Tikere Monda. KwaZulu Natal Province, Little Flower Combined School. Principal is Ubabu Zuma. Overall average 84%. Well done, Puti. Keep working hard. Pusheletso Mkabela is from Limpopo, Jane First Secondary School. Principal again is Ntate Ntake. She comes in with an average of 84%. Well done, Pusheletso. Welcome to the Siyandisa family, and we look forward to seeing you. Alicia Mkachwa, Limpopo Province. I think Limpopo always just outshines all these other provinces. No pressure to all the other provinces. But Limpopo Province, EPP Mhinga Secondary School, principal is Mr. Chauke. Overall average, 81%. Well done, Alicia. Odei Mufukeng is from the Free State, from Mamboi Secondary School. Principal is Mrs. Liebenberg. Overall average for Odei is 86%. Now, Odei, there's no pressure on you, but I will say that Pole Mufukeng, class of 2017, was one of the top achievers in the province. In fact, he was number one in the whole province. And he really did himself, he outdid himself. So there's no pressure on you to outdo yourself, but please, he set the benchmark. So you need to keep the levels. Well done and welcome to Siyandisa Odei. Lesego Mogale is from Gauteng Province, Sikululekile Secondary School. Mrs. Trainee, once again, welcome. And Lesego comes in with an average of 82%. Well done, Lesego. Patience Mukhabudi is from Limpopo Province, Randubeng Secondary School. Principal is Ntate Rapula. 87% Patience. Well done. Naledi Muleleki is from the Northwest Province, Sitsokhosing Secondary School. Overall average of 81%. Well done, Naledi, and welcome to Siyandisa. Genius Muloko is from Gauteng Province, Esibonelwe Sihle Secondary School. Now, Esibonelwe Sihle is such a beautiful name. Such a beautiful Nguni name. Well done, Genius. You come in at 82%. Congratulations and welcome to Siyandisa. Vanessa Moraila from Limpopo, Jane First Secondary School. Principal is Utatu Ntake. Overall average for Vanessa at the end of grade 11 is 85%. Well done, Vanessa. Welcome to Siyandisa. Mohau Muroka is from Limpopo Province, from Dendron Secondary School. Principal is Ntate Matsapula. Overall average for Mohau is 81%. Congratulations, Mohau. Welcome back to Dendron Secondary School. We look forward to seeing more scholars in 2022. I need to wusa with this pronunciation. Rofulufela Mpaka, Limpopo Province, from Mulenga Secondary School. Mem Sirakalala, welcome back. She comes in at 80% at the end of grade 11. No pressure on you either, Ms. Mpaka. It's not like Innocent outdid himself through his achievements, but welcome to Siyandisa. And I hope you'll enjoy your stay with us. Mikay Mpofu. Now, I must say with this name, I had initially thought it's Mickey. And once I had spoken to Utatuo, he then corrected me and said, "Ai, Tiki, it is not Mickey. It is not Mickey. It is Mikay." And you must say it with a Xhosa accent. So it's Mikay Mpofu from the Western Cape. So Phumelela Secondary School, principal is Daduo. Mikay comes in with an average of 81%. Now, while I am on Sophumelela Secondary School, I want to also just acknowledge Sophumelela Secondary School grade 11 class. I know you guys are all there in your hall watching this presentation this afternoon. I just want to acknowledge you and give a shout out and say thank you for joining us. I hope that you get inspired through seeing these learners to also achieve greatness. Thank you. Apiwe Mthuli is from KwaZulu-Natal, Sister Jones Secondary School. Apiwe comes in with an average of 86%. Well done, Apiwe. Unati Nayo is from the Western Cape, Pandulwazi Secondary School, and the principal there is Mrs. Boy. And Unati comes in with 86% overall. Well done, Unati. Keep working hard. Tobani Ndaha is also from the Western Cape. That school again, I'm not even going to twist my tongue right now. Overall average of 87%, Tobani, Inxolele Betunana, igama lesikolo senu. But well done and welcome to the Siyandisa family. Abongile Ngqoyiya is from KwaZulu-Natal, Little Flower Secondary School. Principal is Ubabu Zuma. Abongile comes in at 80% at the end of grade 11. Well done, Abongile. Welcome to the Siyandisa family. Henry Ntlapo is from Free State Province. Retsidisitswe Secondary School in Villiers, and Henry comes in at 82% at the end of grade 11. Well done, Henry. Keep working hard and welcome to the Siyandisa family. Thandeka Nkosi is from Mpumalanga Province, from Buluzi FET School. Thandeka's overall average is 81%. Well done, Thandeka, and welcome to Siyandisa. Sinesipho Phikwa is from KwaZulu-Natal Province, Little Flower Combined School. Principal is Ubabu Zuma, and Sinesipho has achieved 81% at the end of grade 11. Well done, Sinesipho. We then have Israel Prusente from the Western Cape, Sophumelela Secondary School. Utatuhoho, Kito, I hope you're listening. Utatuhoho again. Overall average for Israel is 84%. Anam Kwala is from the Eastern Cape Province, from Stutterheim High School, and Anam's overall average is 80%. Well done, Anam. Mishek Rapasha is from Limpopo Province, from Mamvuka Combined School. Principal is Mrs. Mulawudzi. Overall average, 87%. Excuse me. Well done, Mishek, and welcome to the Siyandisa Foundation. Teboho Silopiani is from Limpopo Province, Dendron Secondary School. Principal is Ubabu Matsapula. Well done and welcome back. Overall average for Teboho is 81%. Ntsako Shiluvana is from Limpopo Province, St. George Secondary School. Principal is Mrs. Varugese. Overall average is 92%. Well done, Ntsako. Keep working hard and welcome to Siyandisa. Murunwa Simango is also from Limpopo, from Zata Secondary School. Welcome, Dr. Sinyosi. Congratulations to Mrs. Sinyosi. She's part of the Siyandisa family. We see scholars from this school every year, and she's recently obtained her PhD. So there's no pressure on you, Murunwa, but well done, and Dr. Sinyosi will guide you. Sibongile Sithole, Limpopo Province, from Harry Oppenheimer Agricultural School. The principal there is Mr. Dibiti. Overall average is 86%. I know I've got a few members in our audience, Mr. Manuel, Mr. Mukhatla from Department of Agriculture. I don't know if they're in this meeting today, but please take note, we do have a scholar from an agricultural school. Luyanda Stierman is from KwaZulu-Natal Province, from Little Flower Secondary School. Again, Babu Zuma. Overall average is 88%. Well done, Luyanda. Lehlohonolo Thapedi is from Free State. Mampoi, once again, no pressure, Lehlohonolo. Pule showed you how it's done, so you can do it too. We believe in you. Well done for achieving your 82% and welcome to the Siyandisa family. Makgobisane Tshehla is from Limpopo province, Jane First Secondary School. The principal there is Ubabuntake. Overall average is 86%. Well done, welcome to our family, and we look forward to seeing you. Lutho Yiba from the Western Cape, Pandulwazi Secondary School. The principal there is Umamo Boy, and Lutho comes in at 81%. Congratulations, Lutho. Welcome to the Siyandisa family. Uziyanda Zungu is our last scholarship recipient for today and this year in our scholarship program. Ziyanda hails from KwaZulu-Natal Little Flower Combined School. Principal there is Babu Zuma, and Ziyanda comes in at 84%. Well done, Ziyanda, and congratulations. Welcome to the Siyandisa family. Ladies and gentlemen, I would also like to ask again, Vanessa, I'm sorry for hassling you today, but I'd like to unmute. I'd like to really celebrate our scholars. I believe they deserve a round of applause, a warm and loud round of applause. Thank you so much. You're an amazing group of young people. Well done. Keep working hard. Let the opportunities find you through your hard work. I'm excited to have you in the program. I'm excited to be working with you in this year and evolving with you as our program evolves. Universities, partners, sponsors, please take note. You have first preference at picking from these scholars, selecting from these scholars and affording them further opportunities. I challenge each recipient to participate, to contribute, to evolve him or herself. So much as you guys have done really, really exceptionally well in your marks at the end of grade 11, I want you guys to push yourselves even further, to get involved, to participate, but to work hard, to really evolve and change yourselves, change your circumstances, change your situations. Well done. Congratulations. As I come to the end of our presentation, I would like to acknowledge our Siyandisa Trust representatives. Thank you so much for making time to see and embrace and welcome our 2021 matriculants, our 2021 scholarship recipients. I would also like to thank the support of our provincial departments of basic education. I would not only like to say thank you to the various departments, but I would also like to specifically acknowledge Professor Ralinala, who has assisted us at the foundation. Even as you're retired, Prof, I know that you are out there. I can't see you now, but I know that you've attended this afternoon's proceedings. Thank you so much to the departments for your support. Thank you for accommodating our program and really just hearing us out, because I cry at the departments, guys. I'd like to thank our strategic partners and our sponsors for all the contributions made towards our scholarship program. I want to again emphasize the impact that your contributions make to our scholars. You have no idea. Every single contribution makes an immense difference. I know that many of our scholars want to thank you in person. And I think perhaps we should share some of these testimonials with you. But every little contribution counts. Every sponsorship, every contribution really, really makes a huge difference. Our scholars are always grateful. And I think because I'm in the forefront, I always get to experience the firsthand emotions, but thank you very much. I would also like to extend my thank yous to our teachers and principals, because without you, none of this would be possible. All these learners are in your hands. All these learners are really the fruits of your hard work. And I want to say thank you. We acknowledge the hard work that you do. It's been a difficult year, but you guys have really shown us how it's done. Thank you very much. I want to thank all the university representatives from the various institutions. I can't acknowledge all of you today, but I know you are there. I want to thank other bursary and scholarship program representatives. I want to thank the Moshal Scholarship Program. I would also like to thank Tepoya Toli. Thank you guys for your support. Thank you for attending. And we look forward to strengthening our relationships and working together to grow South Africa, as we'd said. My closing thought, I've stolen a quote. I'm not allowed to name the source of this quote, but he said such profound words. He shared such profound words from a very important leadership position, I believe, that the future is unknown, but our scholars are known. And I want to repeat that, because when I heard those words, they really sank in. The future is unknown. Tomorrow is not known. The future is 10 minutes from now, still unknown, but our scholars are known. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen. Get involved, journey with us, evolve with us. Let's grow South Africa together. Embrace a scholar, adopt a scholar, afford them the opportunity, change a life, change a community, change this country for the excellence, I think, for the better. I want to say to the class of 2021, as we evolve at Siyandisa Foundation, as I evolve at Siyandisa Foundation, as Siyandisa Foundation evolves, continue to work hard, continue to do what you're good at, and opportunities will find you. Thank you so much for making time to attend our presentation this afternoon. I look forward to further engagements with all our stakeholders. I'm more excited about the scholars because I know you guys have been WhatsApping me, but I couldn't respond. I'm very excited and all the best with the, this is the first day of the second half of the year. And I want you guys to go into the second half of the year, put your best foot forward, do what you can, do what is necessary, and we'll be here to support you. Thank you.